Name a cold-blooded creature.
Lizard.
So there are some.
Yes, there
but there are also.
That's why they like the sun to warm up.
There are also.
Had it on here before. I learnt that on here.
Yes.
Like that.
But I've arrived with new information.
Oh, no.
Simon Cowell.
There are, in fact, warm-blooded lizards and, indeed, warm-blooded fish. Almost all reptiles. You're absolutely right. That's a horrible picture.
That's not a good one, though.
That is a jaggery caiman eating a catfish.
Or the catfish eating a caiman's tongue.
Yeah. almost all reptiles and fish are cold-blooded, so they depend on their surroundings to heat them up. However, in 2015, we have just new news. Scientists have discovered warm-blooded lizards and fish.
Oh, I know.
So that lizard there on the left can heat itself up to 10 degrees warmer than its environment, and nobody knows why.
And the both live together?
No, they don't. Those are... Well, they look surprised, and the fish looks very surprised. It's called an opa fish. It's the only completely warm-blooded fish.
How is it the only one? Is it just really awkward? Sorry, how do you become the only fish that's warm-blooded out of a whole... Or did they just have an overburdened mummy made it a hot water bottle and it just ate it and
but
had an idea?
It's a really good question, because the fact is we don't know how warm-bloodedness evolved.
It ate a hot water bottle.
And then
it looks
decided
like a hot water bottle shape.
Well, was that more prevalent post the wipeout of the dinosaurs? Isn't there a theory that they died because of the change in temperature?
Well, the thing is, dinosaurs were neither warm-blooded nor cold-blooded, but they were somewhere in between.
They were just right, weren't they?
Yeah, they were just right.
They had lovely Goldilocks blood.
Because there are disadvantages to being warm-blooded, OK? Because one of the things is you have to keep eating to get fuel to maintain the constant body temperature. So if, for example, a lion was as big as a Tyrannosaurus rex, it probably wouldn't be able to eat enough to survive.
But isn't there the theory on the dinosaurs where they died out because the over a certain temperature all the eggs hatched as male, and below a certain temperature they all hatched as female, and then the temperature went down and they all hatched as female, and then there were no one to mate with?
Well, there are as many theories about how the dinosaurs
but that's the
were
correct
related.
One
that's
the one that I can vaguely remember. I'm 90% sure is 100% correct.
There's someone who's never watched King Kong. Massive gorilla, mate, twatted all of them.
Spoil the end of that film. No! Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Well, please, come on, pick something.